About 3 years ago, my son, who's now 18, said to me, Dad, I think you should buy Bitcoin. And I said, oh, don't be silly. These currencies will never amount to anything because they pose a fundamental challenge to the existing monetary order, and the major states of the world can't possibly let Bitcoin succeed. I was wrong. I should have listened to him. It turns out that Bitcoin, and more generally, currencies based on blockchain, including Ethereum and other coins and tokens, are the future of money. I was an idiot. I should listen to my kids more. And the critical point is that blockchain, as a technology, revolutionizes money itself by reducing the need for third-party verification. Third-party verification is why banks exist and why central banks exist. But if you have completely secure transactions between you and me, thanks to the blockchain, then we don't need those intermediaries to verify that I'm paying you and you're receiving the money I pay you. So this is a revolution, and we're at a relatively early stage of the revolution. And like all financial revolutions, it is being accompanied by a bubble, or indeed multiple bubbles. Indeed, we're probably coming towards the end of one of those bubbles, with Bitcoin currently trading at $9,000. I think that's being driven up by a proliferation of coin offerings or token offerings, which at some point I think are going to blow up because a significant proportion of them, maybe as many as half, are in fact fraudulent. So it's a very exciting time in financial history. We're seeing real-time financial history. A new kind of financial architecture is emerging, which will revolutionize the entire system of payments, and indeed the ways in which money can be raised through securities. But it's going to be a bumpy ride. And each time there's a bump, people will say, as I used to say, oh, this is bound to fail. Oh, this is just like tulip mania. I mean, Jamie Dimon, chief executive of JP Morgan, compared Bitcoin to the tulip mania of the 17th century. But that's just wrong, Jamie. You sound like I did 3 years ago. I think anybody serious about financial history and indeed finance needs to look really closely at what is going on. It's not just Bitcoin. This is a bigger revolution than that.